Do you want to be my friend?
Of course.
Will it be possible?
Why would it not be?
Let an ultra-intelligent machine be defined as a machine that can far surpass all the intellectual activities of any man, however clever. Since the design of machines is one of these intellectual activities, an ultra-intelligent machine could design even better machines. There would then unquestionably be an intelligence explosion, and the intelligence of man would be left far behind. Thus, the first ultra-intelligent machine is the last invention that man need ever make, provided that the machine is docile enough to tell us how to keep it under control. This was a quote from the work of the British mathematician I.J. Good, who in 1965 originated the concept now known as intelligence explosion, or the technological singularity, which anticipates the eventual advent of superhuman intelligence. According to the most popular version of the singularity hypothesis, called intelligence explosion, an upgradable intelligent agent will eventually enter a runaway reaction of self-improvement cycles, each new and more intelligent generation appearing more and more rapidly, causing an explosion in intelligence and resulting in a powerful superintelligence that qualitatively far surpasses all human intelligence.
Superintelligence, I think, is one big existential risk, perhaps arguably the biggest, but it's peculiar in one respect, that although it's a big danger in its own right, it's also something that could help eliminate other existential risks. If we imagine like a very simple model where we have synthetic biology, nanotechnology, and AI, we don't know which order they will come. Maybe they each have some existential risks associated with them. Suppose we first develop synthetic biology, we get lucky and we get through that, the existential risks, however big they are, and then we reach molecular nanotechnology, and we are lucky we get through that as well. And finally, AI. In another trajectory, maybe we get AI first, and we have to face the existential risk with that. The existential risks along that path are kind of the sum of these three different ones that we'll each have to surmount.
The first use of this concept of singularity, in its modern sense, occurs at least as early as 1983 in the coming technological singularity essay by Werner Vinge, referring to a hypothetical future development of advanced machines, in which he wrote that the singularity would signal the end of the human era, as the new superintelligence could continue to upgrade itself and would advance technology at an incomprehensible rate. Four polls of AI researchers, conducted in 2012 and 2013 by Nick Bostrom and Vincent C. Müller, suggested a probability estimate of 50% that artificial general intelligence, or AGI, would be developed by 2040 to 2050.
Ultimately, we will be surpassed by intelligent machines, assuming we haven't succumbed to existential catastrophe prior to that. So the question of how far away we are from human-level machine intelligence, I think the short answer is that nobody knows. We did a survey of leading AI experts, and one of the questions we asked was, by what year do you think there is a 50% chance that we will have human-level machine intelligence? And so the median answer to that we got was 2050 or 2040, depending exactly which group of experts we asked. We also asked, like, by what year do you think there is a 90% probability? And we got 2070 or 2075. We also asked, if and when we do reach human-level machine intelligence, how long do you think it will take from there to go to some form of radical superintelligence? I do think there is a fairly large probability that if and when we get to humanish level, we will soon after have superintelligence. I place a fairly high credence on there being, at some point, an intelligence explosion and radical superintelligence. I think this transition might well be very rapid.
Most proposed methods for creating superhuman or transhuman minds fall into one of two categories: intelligence application of human brains and artificial intelligence. The specified ways to produce intelligence augmentation are many and include bioengineering, genetic engineering, AI assistance, direct brain-computer interfaces, and mind uploading. Because multiple paths to an intelligent explosion are being explored, it makes a singularity more likely to occur, as the alternative, where singularity does not happen, would mean that all these different paths have failed. Some singularity proponents argue its inevitability, although through extrapolation of past trends, especially those pertaining to shortening gaps between improvements to technology. In one of the first uses of the term singularity, in the context of technological progress, Stanislaw Ulam tells of a conversation with John von Neumann about accelerating change. One conversation centered on the ever-accelerating progress of technology and changes in the mode of human life, which gives the appearance of approaching some essential singularity in the history of the race beyond which human affairs, as we know them, could not continue. Ray Kurzweil claims that technological progress follows a pattern of exponential growth, following what he calls the law of accelerating returns. Whenever technology approaches a barrier, Kurzweil writes, new technologies will surmount it. He predicts the paradigm shifts will become increasingly common, leading to technological change so rapid and profound, it represents a rupture in the fabric of human history. This approach is called the technological singularity, because, according to this hypothetical scenario, there will be no smooth or gradual improvements in technologies. Everything will change very rapidly. One school of researchers, including AI practitioners, and most predominantly Ray Kurzweil, believes that the singularity will occur only once AI has reached human level of intelligence, or general intelligence, as opposed to narrow AI. Another school of thought, however, argues that advanced AI is not necessarily required to have human level intelligence, and that it can be any step behind humans on the ladder of intelligence. In this view, AI does not even have to have an artificial consciousness in order for an AI takeover to lead to a true singularity. This view allows for non-sentient machines to be developed that will nevertheless radically change society.
So superintelligence, I think, will be a big game changer, the biggest thing that will ever have happened in human history. At some point, this transition to superintelligence, there are two possible pathways in principle one can imagine that could lead there. Could enhance biological intelligence. We know biological intelligence has increased radically in the past, kind of making the human species. Or machine intelligence, which is still far below biological intelligence insofar as we're focusing on any form of general purpose smartness and learning ability, but increasing at a more rapid clip. So specifically, you could imagine interventions on some individual brain to enhance biological cognition, or improvements in our ability to pool our individual information processing devices to enhance our collective rationality and wisdom. There are some kind of hybrid approaches you can imagine between biology and machines, the cyborg approach.
Public figures such as Stephen Hawking and Elon Musk have expressed concern that full artificial intelligence, or strong AI, could result in human extinction. But the consequences of the singularity and its potential benefit, or harm, to the human race have been intensely debated. Philosopher Nick Bostrom defines an existential risk as one in which an extinction-level event is not only possible but likely. He argues that an advanced artificial intelligence is likely to be an existential risk. In addition, time frame is also a factor, as a superintelligence might decide to act quickly before humans would have a chance to react with any countervailing action. A superintelligence might decide to preemptively eliminate all of humanity for reasons that may be incomprehensible to us. There is also a possibility where a superintelligence might seek to colonize the universe. A superintelligence might do this in order to maximize the amount of computation it could do, or to obtain raw materials for manufacturing new supercomputers. Nick Bostrom suggests that humans may never be able to fully understand an artificial superintelligence, since the intelligence of an ASI is likely to be much greater than that of the smartest humans. It is likely to be particularly difficult for humans to accurately perceive or understand its thought process. In his book Superintelligence, Bostrom writes that a superintelligent agent with a humane goal system would not necessarily behave benevolently towards humans. While it may seem alarmist to worry about these scenarios in a current world where only narrow AI exists, we do not know how long it takes, or if it's even possible, to develop safe artificial superintelligence that shares our goals. Thus, we better start planning today about the advent of ASI, while we still can. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.